It's no surprise the Bitcoin and shitcoin grifters are striking while the iron's hot. Let's take a look at a new, quote-unquote new, Bitcoin L2, which is going to help your Bitcoin go to work for you. Welcome back, everyone. Spoiler alert, your Bitcoin will not be working for you on these layer twos. No, instead, it's just a whole bunch more shitcoin grifting, just like the previous shitcoin grifting. Anyways, yeah, so I put out this tweet of a screenshot yesterday. Lucky us, another fake L2 for Bitcoin, brought to you by Dan Held and other losers. And it turns out that one of the other losers actually chimed in on my thread, and we're going to go through his response. But before we do, let's take a look at this Mazo grift. Bitcoin Layer 2 Mazo emerges from stealth with 21 million raise led by Pantera. Spoiler alert. A shitcoin is not a Bitcoin layer two, okay? When they take your Bitcoin and then they give you back this fake shitcoin that has the implication that somehow Bitcoin is involved in it, like, that doesn't make it Bitcoin. It's just a shitcoin. All of this is narrative construction and storytelling. That's all this is. Anyways, permissionless Bitcoin economic layer that uses a neutral smart contract infrastructure. That doesn't mean shit. That doesn't mean shit. Like, what is that? Neutral smart contract infrastructure as opposed to the not neutral smart contract infrastructure. Ah, God, guys, this is so pathetic. The funding also involved Multicoin. So if you guys don't know who Multicoin Cap is, you might know Kyle Shamini. Anyways, he's another person that just essentially shills total fucking crap. Let's see. Hack VC, Parify Capital, Nascent Draper Associates, Primitive Ventures, Asymmetric Ventures, and Dan Held and DCF God. Quite the list. It is designed to amplify. Of course, guys, this is the key, right? This is part of the storytelling. It's designed to amplify Bitcoin blockchain's infrastructure and provide cheap and fast transactions by allowing users to access applications that use Bitcoin for everything, enabling a thriving circular economy. It's nothing but vapor. Like, what does that even mean? Like, we already have Lightning for cheap and fast transactions. There's going to be other layer twos that are developed that don't require a shitcoin, that are also most likely going to have reduced fees. So why do we need a shitcoin to do this? We don't. But you know who does need the shitcoin? All of the VCs that back this crap. They need to extract the value as soon as possible, because if they don't, this thing goes to zero, which it eventually will. And of course, it'll be no fault of anyone, of course, right? No fault of anyone's. Mazo will go live with support from Thesis, Bitcoin-backed Ethereum token. Can't even say that. Ethereum-backed token, TBTC. So right there, we didn't even make it. What? We didn't make it halfway through the article. It's already a shitcoin. That's it. Boom. Which allows users to get Bitcoin into Ethereum's decentralized finance DeFi ecosystem. So no, guys, this is the stupidity, okay? You provide your Bitcoin. They issue you a shitcoin, and they simply just write that it somehow contains your Bitcoin. But it doesn't. All they do is take your Bitcoin and give you this valueless shitcoin. And then they pretend that somehow this is making your Bitcoin work for you. Make no mistake, your Bitcoin is working for them, not you. You are the person to fleece so that they can have more Bitcoin, okay? That's all it is. Anyways, Mazo means you can hodl your BTC with purpose, powering the Bitcoin economy, replacing vital online infrastructure, and unlocking the full potential of your BTC. That all sounds like words. Definitely sounds like words. So I was fortunate enough to get a response from Matt Luongo. And let's go take a look at Matt's profile. So founder of this shitcoin Thesis, where we build Fold app. Not a good look for Fold, huh? TBTC project. So there's your shitcoin. The T network embody space. Anyways, I started looking through a lot of this stuff. This is a lot of Web3 absolute fucking nonsensical bullshit. Okay, so here we go. He responded and goes, hey, right here, because I called them losers. He goes, you can call me out directly. I mean, I pretty much did. But anyways, so I've been building on Bitcoin since 2014. You know who else likes to pretend they build on Bitcoin? Dan Held, okay? Like with RSK and funding the ordinal lizards. He's building on Bitcoin by grifting you with vaporware and crap you don't need. What virtue? I don't want to see the this is great. Okay, so this is where a good portion of bullshit comes in, right? I don't want to see the ETF be the only way for people to access BTC. Well, that's great, Matt. Guess what? That's not the only way for people to access BTC. They can buy it, they can mine it, they can earn it. They definitely don't need your fucking shitcoin. That's for sure. That means that we need to scale self-custody, and we need to give people a reason to self-custody by taking their Bitcoin, wrapping it into a shitcoin, and earning yield on it. This is the fucking pretended story you're coming up with. Yeah. Yeah, there's a reason that I don't platform fucking grifters, okay? Like, it's one thing, like, yeah, sure, I'll show their messages and stuff like that, but I'm not going to go and give them an audience where they can sit there and spout their absolute fucking nonsense, because you can see right here, that response is an absolute joke, okay? Right there, he is creating, and you'll notice that he specifically says, I don't want to see the ETF be the only way, because what's happening is that he's understanding that the people most likely reading these idiotic tweets, maybe they bought into the ETF and they're thinking to themselves, hey, wait a second, that's right. I want more exposure, different exposure. I deserve it, right? It's all fucking storytelling, guys. It's complete bullshit. And you know what? Who knows? In 6 to 8 months, we're probably going to be doing some rect segment on this thing. Anyways, Mononaut put out a fantastic thread about this Meso bullshit, okay? And we are going to go through some of the points here, okay? So, because you remember how he was just talking about owning your own Bitcoin? He doesn't want to see the ETFs be the only way for people to access Bitcoin. This means we need to scale self-custody. We need to give people a reason to self-custody. All right, so here we go. In order to effectively ship the product, we launched with a permissioned... I just read that it was permissionless. Huh. Anyways, permission set of... It doesn't matter. It's shitcoining. Who cares? You can just say the magic words. As well as permission sets of guardians and minters. Well, this is starting to sound like a walled garden. This document will explain the ideas behind those changes and what we're doing about it going forward. We will make the signer set permissionless after we have solved some technical obstacles. So for now, you're going to play in our walled garden until we decide it's safe for you to go outside the garden. Now, interestingly enough, what people don't remember from previous shitcoin projects, do you know when the developers give a project out to the wild, right? Once they've extracted all of the value they believe they can and the project is completely fucking dead, then they're like, you know what? Let's let the community have it and build. This is another interesting one, which I also believe is a total red flag, right? If your Bitcoin L2 offers reciprocal rewards based on how much your friends deposit, that's not your L2, that's a pyramid scheme. And indeed, it is a pyramid scheme. So guys, let's not forget all the VCs and people that are backing this pyramid scheme, so that next cycle, you don't sit there and start sucking these people off, right? And pretending like they're wonderful, they're heroes, they're fixing Bitcoin. This is just a giant list of fucking grifters. That's all it is, just grifters, guys. The nail in the coffin right here. If your Bitcoin L2 is backed by an upgradable Ethereum contract controlled by a single company, which this is, that's not your L2. That's a rug pull waiting to happen. Spoiler alert, it is. Now, keep in mind, the article was explaining, more specifically, Matt Luongo, right? The CEO of this garbage was explaining that it's about self-custody. Well, look at this, deposit custody. All deposits in Meso are held as wrapped Bitcoin. Wrapped Bitcoin is issued by either BitPay or BitGo. One of the two, I think it's BitGo. So it's a company that owns wrapped BTC. How it works, you give them your Bitcoin, which means you no longer have custody, and then they issue shitcoin. That's how this works, okay? BTC deposits are bridged to TBTC and held as TBTC in the locking contract. The smart contract used to lock funds is upgradable by the 5 of 9 multisig, which is controlled by Thesis. Okay, so the company that issues the shitcoin controls the multisig wallet and works with another company that pretends to wrap your Bitcoin. This ends well. I'm so excited. So many people are going to get rich, especially the retail noobs that are going to pile into this. They're going to do great. These upgrades will allow additional collateral to be included in the future and enable full bridging experience at the mainnet launch. Part of that bridging experience is going to be the rug pull. I always expose stupid projects like this. You'll notice that I don't waste my time going into the technicals, because that's the thing about grifts, right? Grifters want to drag you. I've said this before. I will say it again. Grifters want to drag you into the woods to get lost with them in their nuance, okay? Because then you're not thinking clearly anymore, and you're not thinking about the things that matter. Like, it's a company that issues this shitcoin, number one. Number two, they take your Bitcoin and they issue you a shitcoin that they create, okay? This is all nonsense. It's all bullshit, okay? And all this is I love Bitcoin, buy my shitcoin. Catch you tomorrow, guys.